So hey everybody, so we have got a project on our hands today. So what we are doing is we are taking this hard drive that I bought 6 to 7 years ago. So this runs on a USB 2.0 interface. So as you can see, it has got a dock that it interfaces through, and this dock has USB 2.0. So because of the drive being so old, this drive is running slow, and I thoroughly believe that this drive can run faster than it actually is running over the USB 2.0. So what we would be doing today is we would be taking the drive, testing it out on the USB 2.0 over this dock on the Crystal Diskmark app, and then we would be popping the drive into the PC over the SATA 6 gigabit per second interface, and then we would be testing again on the Crystal Diskmark app. So let's see if we can make our old hard drive fast enough for us to actually get some decent speeds out of it. So first of all, the issue that I had with this drive takes way too many connectors. One for the power. So this is the adapter for the power that it takes. And this is the cable, the USB 2.0 cable that it takes to connect from the computer, to interface from the computer to the hard drive, right? So my issue with the hard drive is it's taking way too much space on my setup, first of all, and it's engaging way too many slots when it comes to my USB slots and my plugs and my sockets that I have on my extension cord. So I don't want that. I want this drive to be inside my PC. So what I'm going to be doing right now is connecting the drive to the PC. So I hear some vibrations, and I don't know where the wire LED went. Yeah, so there's a white LED on the drive itself. So as we can see, it has opened. The Windows Explorer has opened the drive, and it's showing me the files that it has. So it has a quite significant amount of files. I don't remember what is the size. Yeah, there is 390 GB free of 931. So there's a pretty good chance that around 400 to 500 GBs has been covered by the content. So this is the Crystal Diskmark app that I would be testing on, and since it can take a lot of time on such a slow hard drive and an even small interface that it's communicating through, so I would be putting it through three passes of 500 megabit files. So after I start this, it's writing the files onto the drive, and it's gonna write it thrice, as far as I understand it. It's gonna write it, and it's gonna record the information that it gets, the read and write speeds. So something that you should note here is the sequential read and write speed would always be faster than the random writes. And as soon as I start the read and write cycles, it's gonna capture all the data that it gets, sequential read and write speeds. And as I said earlier, sequential read and write speed would always be greater than the random write speeds. This is because of the reason that the drive is more efficient in writing one big chunk of file at a time, as compared to a few chunks of smaller files at a time. This is something where SSDs shine, since SSDs have greater amount of IOPS, that is input and output per second. And what it does is SSDs can handle loads of data, even random writes and reads, at a greater speed than a conventional hard drive. So as you can probably see, the results we have got across the board aren't really good. So the first reading, as I showed you, is 40 Mbps, so that's not great as well. And even the write is across 40 Mbps. So the thing with these drives is once you are done doing the data read and write, it's not gonna be, for example, if you have games loaded on this drive, I've actually tried some games, and with modern titles, with modern AAA titles having sizes of above 30 GBs, this drive is not gonna perform well, and it's gonna make you wait like hell for the game to load. Now our next step is gonna be taking the drive out of the enclosure, right, and then popping it into the PC itself. So I still use Windows screensaver. As you can see, I'm a pretty old dude. This is basically because my cameraman suggested this would be a cool idea. This would go with my setup, apparently. So I don't believe in that. That's why I just blindsided him and said this in the video itself. So Now, when it comes to taking apart this drive, I've watched some tutorials. I think this is a pretty simple procedure, and if we get stuck somewhere, we obviously would refer to the tutorials, which would completely destroy this screensaver and my cameraman's dream to see the screensaver on my dual display setup, right? So as far as the tutorial goes, the guy showed first to pop this panel and then to pop these two sides, right? So first of all, I have to disconnect the dock. So something that I really liked about this drive, if you have some sort of modified SATA cable or even a simple SATA cable, you can actually put the SATA cable here and run it through SATA 6 gigabit per second right from the enclosure itself, and do not have to buy a separate dock for it. Although Seagate, I believe, has sold separate docks, USB 3.0 docks for this. And to be honest, the drive has been built pretty nicely. As you can see, there is a sort of plastic mesh that is allowing the drive to breathe. And yeah, this shouldn't be hard to get inside. This was the drive that I took out of the enclosure in the previous shot before cutting, and we have to open one of the thumb screws here. So this is the 3.5 inch drive. So by the way, if you're wondering, this is the Thermaltake Commander C31 case, and although I'm not leaning towards making this video as an advertisement for this case, but yeah, I really like the case in that it has a lot of space for multiple hard drives, and as you can see, there's a lot of dust here. But when it comes to hard drive bays, it has 5 hard drive bays. You can mount 2 2.5 inch hard drives, and you can mount actually more than 2 2.5 inch, and these are the 3.5 inch hard drive bays. So this is apparently a 3.5 inch hard drive. And what I have to do is I can either mount it on here, and I can mount it in here also. So either of the places I can mount it. A problem that I face with this case is that the thumb screws don't go too smoothly. So you have to use a screwdriver in order to make sure that the screw goes inside and secures your drive well enough. So I think that is pretty much it. That is the right amount. Now we have to do the cable routing. So after a lot of work that we have done on the PC, we were finally able to successfully get the drive in, connect the SATA power and the SATA data cable. And now we can test it through Crystal Mark again, whether we get some decent increase in speeds or not. Here, I want to recap on the events that took place during the time this video was shot. I tested the drive multiple times, and although the results were significantly better, they were inconsistent to say the very least. This led me to think that there is an issue with the Crystal Disk Mark app and not with the drive itself. But as it turned out, the issue was with my MSI X570 Gaming Pro Carbon Wi-Fi motherboard. And long story short, over the course of 3 weeks, I had to send emails to MSI, visit the service center twice, which is by the way 2 hours away from my place, in order to get a replacement for my motherboard. Finally, I was provided with the replacement, but after all this, I was able to successfully test the hard drive, and instantly we can see the difference in speeds. It's safe to say that we just sped up our drive virtually 3 times just by switching the interface. And not to mention the extra USB port at the back of the CPU and an extra socket to utilize on my power cord. Back to your regular scheduled program. I would consider that our project of making an older drive perform much faster has been successful up until now. When I unload or load a video on this drive, it would be more apparent as to how good the drive performs or how good the benchmarks translate into real life performance. And again, this is a pretty effective way to breathe new life into your hard drives, even if it's an old one. And yeah, this hard drive in fact hasn't been used much, so I'm not planning to retire the hard drive. And for the remaining life of the hard drive, at least what I can say is this hard drive will be performing better than it was doing before. Thanks for watching the video, guys. Do take the time to leave your comments down below about what you would like to see next. And since I have virtually no subscribers, I'll see your comment for sure, since it won't be lost among 100 others. It's been really fun to do this project, and I'll see you in the next one.